So before we get into today's topic, which is a very disturbing one, I would just like to thank all the people who have watched my videos and left comments. I'm sorry that I haven't responded to the comments lately, or dropped any new videos. I've been very preoccupied with finishing my book, which I have almost finished. It's about 95 to 99% done and will be published within the month. So once I get that published, I'm gonna return to YouTube full force and start doing more videos again. I just really, this is just something I needed to get done because this is almost like my life's work, this book. So I'm very excited to be publishing it soon. Enough about that. Just wanted to thank everyone who has commented. As soon as I drop this video, I'm gonna try and go through all the comments and catch up with everyone. As I said, today's topic is extremely disturbing. The video I'm about to show you is extremely disturbing, and it just shows you where we're at as a culture. We're in a very bad place right now. We are in a crisis situation, and people are scared. And there are some very, very sick people who are turning this world into their playground right now. And I'm just want to warn you because even though this video is just part of a regular TV show, it's extremely evil and disturbing stuff. Okay, so here we go. What you're about to see here is a meeting between Marilyn Manson and the Pope. Now, right away, this is how the scene opens. Okay, I don't know what the actual show is like, but this is how the clip opens on YouTube. It's the Pope looking at baby pictures. Okay, immediately you are being shown something. Can see he's flicking through these photos of a young child. Now, look at that expression he just made. I want you to look very closely at the expression that the Pope just made here, okay? You see that? He's looking at baby pictures and he doesn't smile. When people look at baby pictures, they smile. He is looking at this baby picture as if he's evaluating something, like evaluating a piece of meat or evaluating an object. Watch again. He's got a serious expression at first as he thumbs through the pictures. And then what was that expression that he just made? I want you to answer that. What did the director tell John Malkovich to do right there? What expression did the director tell John Malkovich to make as he looks at these baby pictures dressed up like the Pope? Continuing. Oh, and there's the little smile. Not a loving smile. Look at this little sly smile he gives after the nod. Hold up. Hold up. And then the smile. Look at that little evil little smile he gave. Listen, this is important. God damn it. Hold up. Let me fucking go back. He gives a little nod and then an evil little half smile. And here's Manson. Look at this thing.
Beautiful baby, your nephew.
Beautiful baby, your nephew. Okay? Now
Thank you.
look at Manson's reaction. Watch this.
Appreciate that.
Look what he did. Look what he did. Look at the subtleties. I mean, they're not they're showing you something. It's right in your face. But do you see it? He bites his lip. Okay, now we know this is probably not his nephew, okay? We're gonna get to that in a second. Appreciate that. And he bites his lip. Why would he bite his lip like that? Biting your lip usually has a sort of sexual connotation, doesn't it? Or at the very least, a mischievous connotation, because it's extremely deliberate. He's not like licking his chapped lips here. This is a very deliberate gesture. Okay? I mean, how many people can watch this and not know what they're actually seeing here? Marilyn Manson has brought a gift of a child to the Pope. The Pope evaluates it, gives a little nod, and then he gives him the other gift, a painting. Okay? It's right in front of your face. But do you see it? Continuing. Boom. Now let's analyze this, okay? What I interpret here is that they have just sat down together, right? If you go to see the Pope and you bring him a gift, that's pretty much the first thing you do, right? You hand him the gift. But Marilyn Manson hasn't given him the gift yet. Or has he? Or has he? Why would the first thing you do when you meet the Pope would be to show him a baby picture and then give him the gift? Unless they're both gifts, the baby and the painting.
Interesting. Thank you. You're welcome.
So the very first thing he does when he meets the Pope is show him a baby picture in which they're both giving little signals to each other, little physical ticks, little physical signals, this slight little smile by the evil little smile by the Pope and the biting his lip by the Marilyn Manson, okay? We know what this is about. I mean, listen, we're at a point in time at which anyone who denies that the Catholic Church is an international pedophile ring is just an idiot. I mean, there could not be more proof. It's just basically common knowledge. It's just basically common knowledge that the Catholic Church is running an international pedophile ring and have been for probably thousands of years. Okay? But has it ever been out in the open like this? Look at this show. So what brings these two together? Why is a diehard open Satanist hanging out with the Pope? Well, of course, the Pope is a diehard open Satanist as well. And I use the term Satanist lightly. I don't believe in Satan. I don't believe in evil creatures from other dimensions, okay? These people are sick, mentally ill individuals, both of them. All three of them, I should say. The Pope, Marilyn Manson, and John Malkovich. They're all mentally ill people who are abused as children. And this is a point at which we're celebrating evil. This is a show to celebrate evil. This is a show to celebrate child molesters. This is a show to celebrate child rapists and Satanists. Look, I mean, Marilyn Manson makes no secret of what he is. You can take one look at him and see what he is. And if you like his music, you can bend over backwards trying to convince yourself that he's not what he is, even though he's showing you exactly what he is. Now, joint production Sky, HBO, Canal Plus. Wow. Now, I want to ask you a question. Do you seriously believe that a show like this could be made without the approval of the Catholic Church? Literally the most powerful corporation / organization in history that we know of. Do you really think that they could do a portrayal of the Pope without the approval of the Catholic Church? More likely is the fact that the Catholic Church actually sponsored this show, as they do so many other movies that promote their agendas. Oh yes, the Catholic Church is very involved in the entertainment industry, just like the rest of the military-industrial complex is. So this is just something I wanted to show you. I know this, I had planned to do this video months ago when I first saw this clip, and honestly, I couldn't get through it without ranting and cussing and stuff because it makes me upset. That, and you know what really makes me upset is to go read the comments. You know what really makes me upset is to go read the comment section on this video. Maybe we'll do that next time. There's gonna be a part two to this, and we're gonna go to the comment section. Now, I understand that there's been a very recent development with Marilyn Manson, which is why I'm posting this now, obviously. So the comments may have changed a little bit within the past few days. But prior to that, you can easily see that people are just fawning over Marilyn Manson, and they're fawning over John Malkovich, and they're fawning over this show. And a lot of them, they actually know what's being shown here, and they still are entertained by it. I fear for the people who have their eyes wide shut to this. I fear for the people who will watch this clip and not see it. I fear for the people who would watch this clip and not see it and then have someone show it to them and then deny it. I fear for you people. I fear for you people that don't want to see it, what's happening. I fear for you people who want to play politics. You know what politics does? It leads you to support people like this. Because you say, I've literally heard people say that this Pope is the best Pope ever. Not John Malkovich. I'm talking about the Pope we have now, Francis. The pedophile ring has flourished under Francis. None of the policies have been changed. They still have a $1 billion pedophile fund. They still have a policy of shuffling pedophile priests to poor districts so that these priests can molest black and brown people because they've been sued in every first world country on the planet. And in some of the third world countries too. But see, they can buy anybody in the third world country. So when their pedophile priests get caught, they ship them to the third world so they can keep doing what they do. This is the Great Plague. You're looking at the face of the Great Plague right now. If you're worried about the hole in the ozone, you don't know what's going on. If you're worried about the coronavirus, you don't know what's going on. The Great Plague is what's going on. There is no cure for the mentally ill children who have suffered these abuses. And the real curse is that many of them will go on to become abusers themselves, just like these two did. You can absolutely bet that Malkovich and Manson were molested as children, and they suffered extreme forms of child abuse. So yeah, I'm going to come back and I'm going to do a part two. And we're going to look at the comment section next time. And I'm going to show you how many people watch this show and they just love it. And they just love it. And they talk about what a great actor Marilyn Manson is. And they talk about what a great actor the Pope is. Or they crack a joke about child rape. Or they crack a joke about the Great Plague of child abuse. Stay tuned.